My name is Lydia Gramai. I'm a third year PhD student at NYU School of Medicine, and I'm enrolled through the Sackler program. Any lab that you would walk into here, the research that they do matters for something. You know, people aren't just spending money and pipetting things for no reason. You know, some people want to cure cancer, they want to cure Alzheimer's, or maybe they just want to understand a particular pathway, which is, you know, along the lines of what I do. So, like, the pathway that I'm studying may not seem very important to people at first glance, but it's a really important pathway and some really important processes. Like, it's really important for stem cell development, and it's really important pathway involved in cancer progression. I have aims. I have larger scale ideas that I want to pursue in the lab, and you know, I work really closely with Dr. Bach, with my PI, to kind of develop those ideas and figure out which experiments I want to do to answer those questions. But in the day-to-day, a lot of the experiments that I design and execute, I'm sort of, I get to go that on my own, and I get to kind of map out what I'm going to do each day and how I'm going to do it. So, you know, I'll be working at the microscope for a while, dissecting or making microscope slides to visualize my samples. So kind of just day-to-day lab protocols that I'm executing.
My name is Michael Burel. I'm a graduate student here at New York University School of Medicine, and I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. So I kind of, in science, I guess you have two, like, obvious routes. You can go to medical school, or you can do research. And I chose research for two reasons. One, because I'm squeamish, and two, because I like the idea of helping, of my work having this rippling effect, so that I can help potentially millions of people with this one project I'm doing. In Erica Bach's lab, we focus a lot on what's called like basic biology or fundamental biology. We study the really simple basic processes of how cells talk to one another. My project in particular has implications on understanding why some cancers, even after chemotherapy and after radiation and after patients spend, you know, countless dollars and other intangible, you know, emotional trials that they have to go through, the cancer comes back and it's even more aggressive. So I'm interested in why is that happening, and how can we ensure that when we get rid of cancer, we get rid of it?
My name is Alessandro Bailetti. I'm a second year graduate student in the developmental genetics lab. When I was a little kid, for a long time, I wanted to be a system engineer. I was 13 or 14, like, you know, years later, and my teacher taught us about the basic ATCG, I mean, you know, the nucleotides, right? And how those four molecules make, I mean, plus other molecules, made the whole composition of what we are, you know, the genetic code. And I'm like, hold on, so you're telling me that this is based on four specific code, like four nucleotides that become a code? And I started thinking about it, like, how cool is that?
A lot of students don't go into science because they don't think they have quality X or quality Y. I think it's really easy to get discouraged when you look around and you think that you don't have what that person next to you has. I think the ability to look past that and to just do what you love is really a quality I think you need to have.
And if you just find the passion and the thing that makes you want to get up in the morning and be like, I really want to, like, spend 12 hours of my day doing this. And I know that sounds ridiculous, but you will find it, whatever it is. And if you find that and you act on it, you'll be smooth sailing.
The building blocks of science, of life, but the fact that I can understand that, or I'm trying to understand that, for me is fascinating. Remember where you are. Remember that there's so much other things going on around us that we don't have a chance to change. But one thing that we can control is what we do. And if you do that, if you do what you love to do, then the sky is the limit.